Welcome to my channel Exploring Metamedica. In this video, I am presenting to you a review of the Metamedica Pura, the magnum opus of Dr. Samuel Hahnemann. I don't find a better day than the World Homeopathy Day, that is the birth anniversary of Dr. Samuel Hahnemann, to publish this video on Metamedica Pura. Today is World Homeopathy Day, that is April 10th, 2021. Let us pay our tribute to Dr. Samuel Hahnemann, who discovered homeopathy, the natural way of healing. And Dr. Samuel Hahnemann lived between 1755 to 1843. Dr. Samuel Hahnemann, founder of homeopathy, born on 10th April 1755. He lived till 2nd July 1843. This is the Hahnemann's birthplace, that is missing. And he studied in the school of St. Afra Prince School, where Hahnemann studied in the city missing. So he's born to a pottery painter, very poor Christian Gottfried Hahnemann, and mother Gianna Christina, in the town of Missen in Saxony province. And he was the third child, that is of five, and he was one of the eldest son. So when he was a child, he wrote an article, The Wonderful Structure of the Human Hand. His father told him, prove all the things, hold fast, which that is good. So here in 1755, he was a student at University of Leipzig. And in 1777, he worked in hospital at Vienna. And here you can see an image, that is a student, our Samuel Hahnemann. Here you can see an image, that is Erlangen University, from where Dr. Hahnemann got MD degree in 1779. And in 1781, he married to Gianna Leopoldine Henriette Kuchler on 17 November 1781. And you can see the image of Hahnemann as a chemist. And this is the house at Dresden, where he lived from 1784 to 1789. Homeopathy was discovered way back in 1790. And this discovery came because when Hahnemann was translating Cullen's Metamedica, he came across a sentence, that is, cinquenobar cures malaria because it is bitter. This was nothing but apple falling on the head of Newton, similar to Hahnemann, which made him to think and experiment on cinquenobar, which led to the discovery of homeopathy. So here you can see the image of Hahnemann as a physician, and he lived in Torque from 1805 to 1811. So this is the house of Cothen, where he lived. And in Cothen on 8th October 1834, Hahnemann met Melanie from Paris, and 3 months later they married on January 18, 1835 in Cothen. So at this time Hahnemann was 80 years and Madame Melanie was 30 years old. This is the house at Paris, and he passed away on 2nd July 1843. And while dying, he said, non intuitilis vixi, that is, I have not lived in vain. And here we are having Dr. Hahnemann's tomb at Paris, built in his memory. So on this World Homeopathy Day, let us just know the important contributions of Hahnemann. Assuming ascertaining new principles in 1796. Fragmented Iberius, Medicamentorum Positivus, Sivins Anno Corporis, 1805. The Medicine of Experience, 1805. On the Value of the Speculative Systems of Medicine, 1808. Observations on the Three Modes of Medical Practice, 1809. Aurelian of Medicine, 1810 to 1842. And Metamedica Pura, that we are going to know today, is from 1811 to 1833. So let us just try to know the travel history of Hahnemann. He was born in Missen, and he studied in medicine in Leipzig, and he practiced in hospitals of Vienna, and he was a family physician and librarian to governor of Transylvania, with whom he resided in Hermannstadt. And he graduated on 1779 in Erlangen, and he practiced here in a small town called Halberstadt. And in Dessau, his attention turned towards chemistry, and in Gommern, he was appointed as a district physician, and in Dresden he practiced and published many chemical works. In Leipzig, in 1789, published treatise on syphilis. In 1790, translated Cullen's Metamedica. In Georgenthal, he was in charge of an asylum for the insane. And in Königslutter, he lived till 1799. In Dessau, in 1803, he published a monograph on coffee, and he also published various articles in this place. And in Torgen, published his scriptures on ancient medicine, and in Leipzig, he became a very famous practitioner, and He pulled a lot of crowds. And in Khotan, he practiced and developed his system, where he met two of his disciples, that is Staff and Gross, where he communicated to them his theory and origin of coronary disease. He found the first homeopathic society, that is Central Society of German Homeopathists, and married to Madame Melanie in 1835. And in Paris, he brought out second edition of coronary disease, but he was dissuaded from publishing by his wife. And after 8 years in practice, he died on 2nd July, 1843. So on this day of World Homeopathy Day, I would like to present to you a review on one of the magnum opus of Dr. Samuel Hahnemann, that is Mater Medica Pura, which is having two volumes presently with us. I am going to tell you about the volume number one of Mater Medica Pura. As you all know that homeopathic Mater Medica comprises of data from drug proving, poisoning and clinical cures and arranged according to a standard schema, that is which we call as Hahnemannian schema of location from head to foot. So let me just read to you the aphorism 143, where Hahnemann mentions, if we thus tested on the healthy individual a considerable number of simple medicines and carefully and faithfully registered all the disease elements and symptoms they are capable of developing as artificial disease producers, then only have we a true Mater Medica, a collection of real, pure, reliable modes of action of simple medicinal substances. So this he mentions in aphorism 143 of 6th edition. So in aphorism 144 he says, from such a Mater Medica, everything that is conjunctural, all that is mere assertion or imaginary, should be strictly excluded. Everything should be the pure language of nature, carefully and honestly interrogated. So this shows his concern towards preparing a pure Mater Medica, and he called his Mater Medica as Mater Medica Pura. So it was Hahnemann who started this new line of Mater Medica by testing the drugs on himself, his friends and family members. This he called as drug proving, which means proving the curative properties lying in the drugs. So what was special here was, during the several thousands of years over which the history extends, no one fell upon this natural method of first ascertaining the curative powers of medicines before giving them in diseases. So earlier, whatever drugs were given, they were just given on a hypothesis, or some chemical properties of the drugs were known and they were just applied without a proper experimentation. And it was Hahnemann who thought of experimenting these drugs on human beings and then knowing the characters of these drugs and then applying on the sick. So as you all by now know that 1790 is called as birth of homeopathy. So while Dr. Hahnemann was translating William Cullen's Mater Medica, he came across a sentence about cinchona bark, that it cures malaria because it is bitter. So after that, Hahnemann tested this drug, cinchona, on himself, his friends and also family, and everyone started producing malaria-like symptoms. And this, when he gave to the people suffering with malaria, it removed the symptoms of malaria. So he came to the conclusion that like cures like. So what is needed was, we need to know more about the curative power of the drug substances. So after this, Hahnemann started testing drugs one after other, and this process of drug proving became the basis of Mater Medica Pura that we have today, and the first part, which was published in 1811. Hahnemann called his Mater Medica as Mater Medica Pura because it contains the pure effects of the drugs as observed in healthy human beings of different ages and both the genders. It did not consist any information collected from any other sources, and after him many others started proving the drugs, and thus we have a vast source of Mater Medica for homeopathy which was created by the efforts of Hahnemann. And later on, symptoms other than those found during the proving were also incorporated. So Mater Medica Pura is a Latin word, and in Germany it is called as Rhein Arzneimittler, is one of the most important source book of homeopathic Mater Medica. So first edition of Mater Medica Pura consisted of 6 volumes, and the first volume of Mater Medica Pura was published in 1811, and it contains the pathogenesis of 12 medicines, and they are Belladonna, Dulcamara, Cinna, Cannabis sativa, Cocculus indicus, Nux vomica, Opium, Moschus, Oleander, Marksol, Aconite and Arnica. So in the first edition, the second volume of Mater Medica was published in 1816, and it contained 8 medicines together with those ascribed to the magnet. that is causticum, arsenic, ferrum, ignatia, pulsatilla, rheum, rustox, bryonia, magnes, north and south pole. Third volume of first edition was published in 1817 with 8 medicines, and they are chamomilla, cinchona, helleborus, aserum, europium, ipecac, scilla, stramonium and veratrumal balm. Fourth volume of first edition was published in 1818 with 12 medicines. They are hyoscyamus, digitalis, aurum, guaiacum, camphora, ledum, ruta, sarsaparilla, conium, chelidonium, sulfur and argentum nitricum. So coming to the fifth volume of first edition, which was published in 1819 with 11 medicines. So they are euphrasia, minianthus, cyclamine, sambucus, calcarea astica, muriatic acid, thuja, taraxacum, phosphoric acid, spigelia and strepsiaglia. The sixth volume of first edition, which was published in 1821 with the 10 medicines, consisted of angustura, manganum, capsicum, verbascum, colocynth, spongia, drosera, bismuth, cicuta virosa and stana metallicum. So let us brief it. Metra Medica Pura, first edition was published between 1811 and 1821, which consisted of 6 volumes, and totally there were 64 medicines, of which 22 were taken from fragmented herbs and others were newly proved. In the first edition, the volumes contain no contribution from the fellow provers. So the second recommended edition of Metra Medica Pura or Rhin Arsene Mettler were published in volume 1, that is 1822, volume 2, 1824, volume 3 and 4 in 1825, volume 5 in 1826 and volume 6 in 1827. So this second edition was a revised edition consisting again of the same 6 volumes and 69 medicines. In the 6th volume, ambergrisia, carbonylis, carbovich were introduced for the first time, and pathogenesis of fellow provers is supplied and largely augmented, and there were 37 provers. So among the 6 volumes, only the first and the second volume came up to third edition, and the remaining 4 volumes remained only up to second edition. So the volume number 1 was published in 1830 and volume number 2 was published in 1833. So these only volume 1 and volume 2 went up to third edition, and causticum from second volume is transferred to chronic diseases. And the main change that has taken place has been the amalgamation of all symptoms of Hanuman's own observations with those of others into one continuous schema, and pathogenesis increased in more instances. So let me just brief the publisher's note to the first Indian edition. Metra Medica Pura was the maiden work of Hanuman, the master of homeopathic philosophy and practice. It offers a challenge of purity to its counterpart of the traditional school. So let us just try to know what are the contents that we have in Metra Medica Pura Volume 1. It begins with translator's preface and followed by author's preface, which is taken from Volume 1 of 3rd edition. Spirit of homeopathic medical doctrine, which is taken from Volume 2 of 3rd edition, and preamble again, which is taken from Volume 2nd of 3rd edition. And the medicine that we have here is from aconite to ipecac, that is a total of 37 medicines. So now just let us go to the translator's preface, that is by Ari Dudgeon, where he says that Metra Medica as left to us by Hanuman consists of 6 volumes, 2 of which, that is volume 1 and 2, had reached a third edition, while the remainder did not go beyond the second. So volume 1 was published in 1830, which is the third edition, volume 2 in 1833 again, which is the third edition, and volume 3 and 4, which were published in 1825, which are the second edition, and volume 5, 1826, and volume 6, 1827, which is again the second edition. So in the earlier editions, the pathogenesis of various medicines are not arranged in the same ways they are in the latest. Thus in the former, Hanuman's own observations are put first and by themselves and separately numbered, the symptoms observed by his disciples under his superintendence and those derived from the work of other observers being arranged together in a different list and specially numbered. And in the third edition, to which only the first 2 volumes attained, the arrangement is different. Here all the symptoms of each medicine, whether observed by Hanuman himself or his disciples, are taken from old school authorities, are combined in one schema and numbered continuously. Harman's own observations being distinguished by having no name or sign attached, while those of his pupils are indicated by an abbreviation of the name of each appended to the respective observations. And the authorities of the old school are named after the symptoms for which they are responsible. So another peculiarity in the work, as it has been left to us, is that the medicines are not arranged alphabetically. Each volume contains a varying number of medicines arranged alphabetically according to the common German names, but there is no attempt to maintain the alphabetical arrangement in respect to the whole work. So now let us know what are the alterations introduced by the translator. There's indication of the name of the proverb by an abbreviation printed in italics, and name of old school authorities for symptoms are printed in small capitals, and symptoms with no name or abbreviations are those observed by Hanuman himself. And if the work has been translated as such, that is the German original, this would give six volumes of various sizes and their contents differently arranged, and it would reproduce the work as it exists in the German original, but it would like that be difficult to use as a book of reference. And if the minor details of the German work were also preserved, it would involve a considerable additional amount of printing without advantage for the reader. Ari Dajan, for the convenience of the readers, he condensed all the six volumes, that is the third edition of first and second volume and second edition of the remaining four volumes into equal sized volume 1, that is Mathematica Pura volume 1 and Mathematica Pura volume 2. So let us know where the Brewers. Adam, a Russian physician, von Gershoff, a nobleman residing in Eisenach, Nanning, a surgeon who furnished many of the symptoms for the Mathematica of Heart Club entrings, from whose work Hanuman took some symptoms indicated by the abbreviations of their names, HBTS, that is singly or conjointly. Others are Hanuman disciples, and the staff name is in NM Upstarts. Many of the symptoms have the time of the occurrence after taking the medicine. This is indicated by contractions between the brackets, that is here M means minutes, H hours, and D days. So Ari Dajan's translation was not the first of Hanuman's Mathematica Pura. In 1846, it was published by Dr. Hempel, but as Dr. Hibbs has pointed out, Hempel's translation is extremely imperfect. So later, Dr. Quinn translated Mathematica Pura. The first volume was completed and printed, but was destroyed by a fire at printing press. The only copy saved is in the library of British Homeopathic Society. It has neither preface nor even a little title page. The first volume is translated from the second edition, but the medicines it contains do not altogether correspond with the original. The arrangement of symptoms is not that of Hanuman. So let us go through the annotation by Dr. Richard Hooks. Dr. Richard Hooks assisted Dr. Dajan in preparing this Mathematica Pura. Hooks refers to the Hanuman's quotations from authors, and he says that these are absent from few of his pathogenesis and in many are very numerous, so as to number in the whole Mathematica Pura up to 4000. So citations can be satisfactory when verified from the original sources and reviewed from thence. It often adds to the value of a symptom that we should know the object and circumstances of its occurrence, the dose by which it was produced, and so forth. Hanuman rarely gives such information. And translation of the Mathematica Pura was made as accurate as possible by the assistance of Dr. Richard Hooks. Dr. Richard Hooks traced the symptoms of the experiments to the day books of the Brewers, and which illuminated the isolated phenomenon and sensations presented to us to show their occasion, their order, and their termination. And Hanuman cited symptoms were traced to their originals, that is, Frank and Wernham for arsenic, Gerstel for aconite, Weizsäcker for colocynth, Roth and others for dulcamara, Langens for opium, moschus, and cannabis. Richard Hooks worked as a co-laborer with Dr. Allen in his encyclopedia and extended his investigations to every drug in Mathematica Pura and chronic diseases. So on the first mention of any authority in each pathogenesis, he has stated the nature of his observations, and to each symptom that has required it, he has appended such explanations and corrections as might be necessary to set it forth in its full meaning and value. And all these matter will be found in the notes at the bottom of the pages, designated by small figures 1, 2, etc., and divided by line from Hanuman's own annotations, which have the usual star and the cross mark and see. So here, Richard Hooks plays a very important role in making this Metamedica pure. The author's preface, that is Dr. Samuel Hanuman's preface, which was taken from volume 1 of 3rd edition, which was published in 1830, where every possible care Hanuman has taken to ensure purity, to know the true power of each medicine substance. And he tried to see that every prover is as healthy as possible and under regulated external conditions as nearly as possible. Even after taking full care with respect to proving, if extraordinary circumstances happen from without, it may be the shock, vexation, fright, an external injury of considerable severity, overindulgence in something, from that time no symptom that occurred in this experiment was registered, as there was suspicion of impurity in such conditions. And if there were little circumstances during the experiment which will not interfere much with respect to the effect of medicinal substance, such symptoms were subsequently noted and were enclosed within the brackets as not certainly pure. So with respect to the duration of action ascribed to each medicinal substance, which Hanuman endeavors to determine by repeated experiment, and he states that it was only learned from experiments on the healthiest persons, and a work on Metamedica should exclude all mere assumptions and empty speculations. So just let me show you the image of author's preface, where Hanuman mentioned that the smallest possible quantity of medicine in potentized development is sufficient for this purpose. And the usual order of the symptoms is as follows, that is, it begins from vertigo and it ends with the disturbance of disposition that is affecting the mind. Let me go to the another content of Metamedica Pura, that is Spirit of the Homeopathic Medicine and Medical Doctrine, which was published in volume 2 of 3rd edition in 1833. So where Hanuman says that life can only be known empirically from its phenomenon and manifestations, and no conception can be formed by any metaphysical speculation. Human life is not regulated purely by physical laws as seen in inorganic substance, and it is regulated by laws peculiar to vitality alone. So here Hanuman says that a nameless fundamental power reigns the condition of sensibility and activity necessary to the preservation of the living whole, a condition almost spiritually dynamic. That is where he talks about the vital principle. And in disease, the dynamically altered condition that is expressed solely by alterations of sensation and functions, and removal of all these morbid symptoms can be called as health. So in this doctrine, Hanuman speaks about susceptibility and predisposition. The susceptibility of the living organism for natural disease is incomparably less than it is for medicines. So as we know that we are continuously exposed to the surroundings, the change in the weather, the noxious agents, but it is very rare that we get sick. So if we are affected by every stimulus, there is nothing called as health. And this individual is so little liable to be affected by such noxious that they can never unconditionally make him ill, and that the human organism is capable of being deranged to disease by them only by means of a particular predisposition. So if we have a predisposition, we get deranged by such an oxygen. So Hanuman in this doctrine says that every true medicine acts at all times under all circumstances on every living animated body and excites in it the symptoms peculiar to it. So that evidently every living human organism must always and inevitably be affected by the medicinal disease, and as it were infected, which was is well known is not the case with respect of natural disease. So we are not easily affected by natural disease, but we all have a tendency to get affected by the dynamic drugs. Human organism in health is more capable of being affected by medicine than by disease. So it is affectable in the highest degree in disease condition. So we may get a question, how these immaterial inimical doses act in disease. So as in disease, the susceptibility is very much altered, and these medicines can act very easily in disease than in the health. So in this doctrine, Hanuman says that there is no case of dynamic disease in the world whose symptoms can be met with in great similarity among the positive effects of a medicine which will not be rapidly and permanently cured by this medicine. The diseased individual can be freed from his malady in no more easy, rapid, certain, reliable, and permanent manner by any conceivable mode of treatment than by means of homeopathic medicine in small doses. So these homeopathic medicines in small doses, the disease causing property of which is known by proving the drugs on healthy human beings itself is the disease curing property in a sick individual. So in the preamble of Metamedica Pura, which has been taken from volume 2nd of 3rd edition, which was published in 1833, for every individual case, physician must be accounted with the medicines that have till now been investigated with respect to their positive action. And Hanuman says that physician must do his endeavor to prove thoroughly to himself and other healthy individuals medicines that have not been yet investigated to increase our store of known remedial actions. And this he mentioned in Arianon of Medicine, 4th edition, in aphorism 111 to 136, with respect to how to conduct drug proving. So, with respect to mode of preparing medicinal substances, he has mentioned in Arianon of Medicine, that is aphorism 267 to 269, and in the second part of the chronic diseases. And the proving can be conducted by globules moistened with the diluent, development of power. And as per desire of many friends, Hanuman did not like to give his cases that he has treated, but as per the demand of many of his friends, he mentions a case of bryonia and a case of pulsatilla in the preamble. With respect to the symptoms produced by his disciples, he questioned, respecting the symptom that they observed, in order to get as precisely as possible the verbal expressions of their sensations and sufferings, and to ascertain with exactness the conditions under which the symptoms occur. And he also took care about the regulation in the diet, and that the provers had led a life undisturbed by passions during their provings. So we can call Metamedica Pura as the purest of all Metamedicas. In the preamble he mentions, it was not until the first volume of the first edition that we published that Hanuman obtained any assistance from others in his proving. And this is the reason of the appearance of these last two paragraphs in the second volume, in which volume they are still retained in the last two editions. So to come to an end, Metamedica Pura is Dr. Samuel Hanuman's magnum opus, and this was the first ever recorded Metamedica in the world, and it is the source book of all subsequent Metamedicas. Whatever Metamedicas we have originated from Metamedica Pura. And the reader can go back to the origin of the symptom in the prover. And so now we can consider that it is a wealth of knowledge. So my dear friends, these are the references. Hanuman's Arianon of Medicine by B.K. Sarkar, and Arianon of Medicine by Hanuman by BGN Publishers, and Hanuman's Metamedica Pura Volume 1 by BGN Publishers. And this is from the net accessed regarding the introductory part of Metamedica Pura. I thank everybody for staying with me throughout the video. If you like the video, please subscribe and don't forget to hit the bell so that you will receive further videos. If you like, please share among your friends. And my dear friends, learning is a continuous process, so keep learning. Thank you. Thank you one and all.